Recall that we started with the problem of designing a robot that can walk on water. Let us suppose that that particular target problem results in the retrieval of a source case of a robot design that we've already encountered, one that can walk on ground. Now the question becomes, how can we adapt this particular design of a robot that can walk on ground into a robot design that can walk on water? Let us now suppose that we reuse this particular problem of designing a robot to walk on water as a probe into the case memory. And now the case returns to us the design of the basilisk lizard. That might happen because the design of the basilisk lizard is indexed by its functional model, walk on water. So there is a pragmatic similarity between the two. We now have the design of a robot that can walk on ground, and we have the design of a biological organism, the basilisk lizard, that can walk on water. For the basilisk lizard, we also have a complete model, a complete explanation of how its structure achieves its function. Now that we have a partial design for the robot, this is the design of the robot that can walk on ground, and we have a design of an organism that can walk on water, we can try to do an alignment between these two. This alignment will be based on the similarity between relationships. Clearly, the objects here and the objects there are very different. Once we have aligned these structural models of the robot that can walk on ground and the basilisk lizard that can walk on water, then we can start doing transfer. We can transfer specific features of the structure of the basilisk lizard, for example, the shape of its feet, to this model of the robot that can walk on ground in order to convert it into a robot that can walk on water. Having constructed a structural model for this robot that can walk on water, then we can try to transfer the behavioral model and then the functional model. And in this way, we have a complete model of a robot that can walk on water along with an explanation of how it will achieve its function. This is sometimes called compositional analogy. We first do mapping at the level of structure, and that mapping at the level of structure helps us transfer some information. That in turn allows us to transfer information at the behavioral level. Once we have transferred information at the behavioral level, we can climb up this abstraction hierarchy and transfer information at the functional level. We can now revisit our computational process for analogical reasoning. Initially, we had presented this particular process like a linear chain, retrieval, mapping, transfer, evaluation, and storage. In general, however, there can be many loops here. We may do some initial mapping, for example, and that may result in some transfer of information. But that transfer then may lead to additional mapping, and then to additional transfer, and so on. Here is another brief example from biological-inspired design. In this case, we want to design a robot that can swim underwater in a very stealthy manner. This particular function of swimming underwater in a stealthy manner reminds a design team of a copepod. A copepod is a biological organism that has a large number of appendages. It moves underwater in such a way that it generates minimum wake, especially when it moves very slowly. On the other hand, when it moves rapidly, then the wake becomes large. When the wake is small, then its motion is very stealthy. When the wake is large, its motion is no longer stealthy. Analogical transfer of knowledge about this particular copepod gives us a design for the microbot for slow velocities. This analogy decomposes our original design problem. We had the original design problem as moving underwater in a stealthy manner. Now that we have a design of an organism for moving underwater at low velocities, we are still left with the sub-goal of moving underwater at high velocities. The goal of designing a microbot that can move underwater in a stealthy manner at fast velocities may remind the design team of the squid. The squid uses a special mechanism like the jet propulsion mechanism to move underwater in a stealthy manner at pretty high velocities. Now we have created the design of a microbot where part of the design comes from the design of the copepod and the other part comes from the design of the squid. Instead of borrowing the design from one source case, we are borrowing parts of the design from multiple source cases. This is a compound analogy. Notice that there's a problem evolution going on. We started with one problem. We arrived at a partial solution to that, which then leads us to a problem evolution, a problem transformation. We now have a new understanding of the problem. So in this example, we saw how we first did analogical retrieval of the copepod organism, then mapping, then transfer. That then led to additional retrieval, in this case of the squid. Once again, this process is not linear. Just like we can iterate between mapping and transfer, similarly, we can iterate between transfer and retrieval.